Now to a story getting huge coverage around the world. Passengers have described the horror moment an Auckland-bound flight nosedived, sending people flying across the cabin and injuring around 50 on board. An investigation's underway into the LATAM flight from Sydney as some criticise the Chilean airline's response. Jacob Johnson covered our breaking news live last night. He has today's developments.
That's the ceiling where people hit their heads on the roof.
Yeah.
A moment of mid-flight mayhem.
I think you'll see it and then put your seatbelt down, all right?
After this plane froze and suddenly dropped for around 10 seconds.
We didn't know if we were going to make it or not. It was terrifying. It was a horror movie scene. I saw people flying to the roof and then going down to the floor.
Someone quite badly injured over that side.
The plane landed in Auckland an hour later.
Has it been crying since?
Around 50 people were treated for injuries, 12 of them taken to hospital, including this Brazilian passenger who fractured two of her ribs.
Estou sentindo muita dor. Fiquei 12 horas no hospital até se resolver e ser atendida.
I was without the seat belt and I flew two seats back, and when I opened my eyes, I was on the floor.
In a statement, LATAM says the plane experienced a strong shake during flight after a technical problem on board. Chilean officials are now investigating the incident, requesting local help given the plane is still in Auckland.
New Zealand's Transport Accident Investigation Commission says it's in the process of gathering evidence, including the cockpit voice and flight data recorders.
Passengers have criticised LATAM's response, saying there was no communication about what happened during the flight.
They just said, you know, just stay in your seat. And then when we got off the plane, they didn't tell us anything.
I've called LATAM twice. They didn't know anything about it. They were like, oh, I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened.
This group was supposed to catch a second flight to Chile on the same aircraft last night. After being put up in a hotel, they're due to fly tonight on a different LATAM Airlines plane.
I'm really considering getting the flight back to Australia because I'm too scared to fly for another 11 hours with the same company.
Rethinking their next steps after such a harrowing ordeal.
And Jacob's with us now from Auckland Airport. Any update on the injured, Jacob?
Look, Simon, currently just four people remain in hospital in a moderate but stable condition. A child was also taken to Starship Hospital last night in a moderate condition, but the hospital hasn't given us any update on that child's condition, citing privacy. Now, as I mentioned in my story, Auckland was just a layover as part of this service, and the group I spoke to today, despite their reservations, I'm told, have now checked in and will be getting on tonight's plane. They're currently just waiting over in the corner here and will be shortly going through these departure gates after what has been a very terrifying incident.
There's another aviation issue too. Air New Zealand today suspending one of its long-haul flights because of engine issues. Tell us more.
Yeah, you're right. Look, this is a completely different issue. Air New Zealand is pausing its Auckland to Chicago service from the end of the month until October because of ongoing challenges around the availability of Trent 1000 engines. Those are the ones it uses on its Boeing 787 planes, and other airlines are facing similar issues with the availability of those engines right across the world. Now, Air New Zealand says this was a tough decision to make, but this service is one that results in the lowest number of customers impacted.
At Auckland Airport, Jacob Johnson, kia ora. Well, this latest incident again puts the Boeing 787 aircraft under the global spotlight. So what could have gone wrong? Abby Wakefield's been talking to experts.
Breaking news on a major incident on board a flight from Sydney to Auckland.
Many of the 272 on board tossed around the cabin of the Boeing 787 Dreamliner.
Every passenger's worst nightmare, making headlines across the world.
It's worse than falling off a cliff. So the aircraft was forced down, people are hitting the roof.
It's a force of 2 or 3 Gs.
Commentator Geoffrey Thomas thinks the mid-air plunge could be linked to a malfunction with the aircraft's systems.
This is rather strange because normally with a wind shear event, it lasts a little bit longer and there's more oscillations. This was just a very sharp up and down vertical speed change, and then it recovered. To me, it seems to point to a computer malfunction.
The Boeing 787 aircraft has been used for passenger flights for more than a decade, and there's around 1,000 of them in use.
It has a perfect safety record and not very many incidents. So this is a really unusual situation, which is going to require some investigation.
Some issues have been raised in the past. Last year, US authorities warned leaky taps posed a risk to the aircraft's electronics. And last month, the same plane suffered from a faulty generator while trying to leave Auckland.
Passou dentro do avião mais de duas horas e ele dizia, resolveu, fecha as portas, porta em automático, e não sei o quê, e nada.
Boeing's been under increased scrutiny since a panel fell off a 737 MAX aircraft in January. The incident's now the subject of a criminal investigation. And today, a former employee who raised safety concerns was found dead days after giving evidence in another lawsuit. As for passengers who may be nervous about flying...
Keep your seatbelt on.
This mid-air drama showing why flight safety shouldn't be taken for granted. Abby Wakefield, One News.
And check out our website, onenews.co.nz, for extra coverage of this mid-air drama, including a look at other recent flights rocked by strong movement.